Both supporters and opponents of the state gasoline tax gathered in front of the state house to defend their position on October 15. Ballot question 1 presents an opportunity to either keep or repeal an automated yearly increase in the existing gas tax.
The legislature said, let's index the gas tax to inflation. That's a teeny increase every year, assuming inflation stays fairly low. And that teeny increase of not even 4 cents over the next five years will give us $1 billion over the next 10 years. And I've said to Charlie Baker time and time again, I said, Charlie, if you don't support indexing of the gas tax to inflation, then where would you get the $1 billion over the next 10 years to buy new rail cars, to do deferred maintenance, to do the Green Line, to rebuild South Station, to take in the new trains that are going to come in? He's never had an answer to that.
People voting no on question 1, who want to keep the gas tax indexed, are worried about a crumbling state infrastructure. But those who support removing the gas tax from indexing are concerned with possible taxation without representation and what some view as irresponsibility on behalf of the Massachusetts legislature.
We are in favor of question 1, to repeal the indexing of the gas tax, because it disproportionately impacts small businesses, those businesses that have one, two, or three or more vehicles, those businesses that have the equipment that has to run, that use their vehicles to get to the job. It disproportionate impact on those businesses in rural areas, and I guess maybe even more importantly, it's bad government.
Because of the strong opinions both sides have sparked, it's going to be a close call for question 1 this November 4th.
From the Massachusetts State's House, I'm Kelly Thomas.
And I'm Alexandra Prim, reporting for Emerson College.